Following video is rated M for strong language and idiotic mistakes. May contain spoilers with attitude.
You have been warned.
So we're looking for that.
Great.
What?
I can't read any of this shit.
But you can't read?
I can help.
Yeah, thanks.
We look out for each other.
Don't overdo it. This is the one. Where's this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alelairo? I'll go look it up.
Alelairo. That means every kind of fur in German.
Donkey skin.
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin. Also known as Askin, prefers to go by the name Faith. Poetic?
Buffkin, we don't need the commentary.
Yeah, but the commentary is kind
of
funny.
The story of Donkey Skin. There was once a great king with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search,
it became
clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was...
What?
His daughter. Faith.
Ooh.
She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty. And they lived happily ever after.
Shit.
Should I mark it, Miss Snow?
Yes. Please.
Wait, why is Cinderella classified?
What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than
her
we...
Her name was Faith.
Yeah.
Hey, Audie!
You should talk to her.
You think he did it?
This sort of thing, it's usually the person who knew them best.
Or it's someone completely random.
It's because the guy, the bigger guy, it's a comparison thing, that's what's going on.
Any information on fables in our community will be somewhere in these books. We already know her name, but feel free to have a look if you like.
Oh my... Okay. Guys, check this out. Look at this. Look how fucking demonic they look like. Like, she looks all nice and kinda... lonely. The gnomes! Or dwarves, in this case, dwarves. Look like they will eat your soul.
Yeah, dwarves. Less said about that, the better.
Wait, they didn't... No, they... No, okay.
Yeah, that's me. Back when... long time ago.
Yeah. You know, this is like one of those things where you're like, you hope to God that they're just friends.
Haven't seen him in a while.
Well, that's how you looked when we met, remember?
And him.
The woodsman?
Yep. And his axe.
Yep. He seems to remember that part the most.
And the two of them. I wonder what the story was. Beauty in happier days. And her man, Beast.
Funny.
Colin.
And his brothers. Yeah, that's her, all right. Time ago. Ichabod Crane. Scared shitless.
What's that?
Your boss. His finest moment.
Marked in history.
I don't understand how he ended up running this place.
Well, maybe it's time that changed.
You know, I'm kinda with Snow on this one.
I haven't seen Badger around for a while.
He likes his privacy, I think.
I wish Toad would like his a bit more. Nice hat.
Feel like I should get Toad a nice hat. Might be productive. Alright, mirror, mirror, on the wall.
Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
Faith.
Show me faith.
Through powerful magic, her whereabouts concealed. Unfortunately for you, these lips are sealed.
What?
These lips are sealed. It's not my choice of phrasing, Bigby. It's simply the way this has to be.
Show me Faith's father, the old king.
So he's dead?
That crosses him off the suspect list. He's a prince, I think. Show me Prince Lawrence.
Dead as well?
What's he been doing? Where is this?
Where's what?
Do you know where Prince Lawrence lives?
If he's a prince, probably relocated in the South Bronx. Yellow building, red window shutters.
Red frames.
Yep, that's the one. I can take us there.
You know, I can't remember, was it Beauty or was it Snow White that said these lips are sealed? No, it was actually Faith said it.
Nobody right now.
Anything we can use?
Yeah, That'll have to do for now.
Come on, we're going over there. Sorry, I have to get that.
Oh, come on, let me get that. I promise if it's a telemarketer,
hello,
they'll
Woodland's
never call again.
Office. Yes, I... He is. Hold on. Bigby.
So it was Faith.
Bigby, it's me, Toad. You there?
What do you want?
Bigby, shit. Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things. Get over here, Bigby, before he... Oh, wait, hang on.
Toad? Don't...
Boy, shit. Hey!
Damn it, Toad. Okay.
What was that about?
Hard to say. Something going on over at Toad's place.
What about Faith's husband?
I don't know. I couldn't really tell. But he could be in trouble. And we should go there anyway to search her apartment. Toad might have to wait.
I don't know. I feel like we should...
Whenever you're ready.
Do I get a choice on where to go? I hope I do. Because I kind of feel like we should head to Toad's first.
Did Toad say who was there? Was it the woodsman?
I don't know. It's possible. Whoever it was, it didn't seem like Toad was happy to see him.
Well, maybe Prince Lawrence can wait.
Yeah, he didn't see him. He could use some help, too.
Well, where to first?
Toad.
Bigby, shit. Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things.
You think he did it? What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
Toad sounds like he needs help right now. We can check in on Prince Lawrence.
Okay.
Glass slipper
shoes.
I'm looking
forward to breaking the news to him anyway.
Little too on the nose, but that's okay.
And we ended up going out the window, and I landed on Toad's car.
You guys made a real mess.
And his car is still...
Looks worse than the day.
Oh, shit. We took out half a wall, too. We didn't just
is
take out a window. Let's go take a look. Let's not give him any idea that we're here.
Wait here.
Better not be gone by now. Damn it, what the hell?
Shit.
Seeker Ichabod Crane is Headless Horseman. The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. He's the guy that basically gets his head chopped.
I'm so That's enough, all right? Just shut it!
Sounds like Clementine.
I don't even remember half of this shit. Helen doesn't make this much of a mess.
You know? Can I pan the camera around? Or is that at that? Alright, so it is kind of locked in play.
What kind of asshole swings a lamp at a guy?
The guy? The same guy that swings a damn axe at your head.
Woodsman never did much reading anyway.
It's kind of cute how the Bigby is. I read her. Whoa! Rago's going in! If I had the points, I would. I don't have the points. What the hell's going on? Sleepy Hollow was an awesome show. I love that show.
Is that his son?
Toads? I think.
Be nice in there, okay?
Do you have to say it?
Hey, Toad. You in there? Bigby! And Miss White! Surely you didn't come all this way just
you
for my
brother. You hiding his sons from Crowell Kid. What the hell did you do to your boy?
Sorry, Bigby. It's embarrassing to have to admit, but I thought it was someone else in Woody's place. It wasn't, though.
Sorry, Rago.
Nothing but
sorry,
a naked drain pipe.
Sorry,
imagination must have got the best of me. So, you know, false alarm. Sorry for dragging Miss White into this.
We heard someone crying.
Oh, the boy stabbed his pillow on the bedframe is all. It stings, you know, but it's nothing to kick up a fuss about. A little tub swim, he'll be right as rain, I'm sure.
You're lying, Toad. Why are you lying, buddy?
Are you all right?
Oh, he's fine, Miss White. Just stung his little toe. Better swimmer than Walker, just like his dad.
Wanna...
So, I guess you'll be taking off now. No need to hang around here anymore. I mean, I'm sorry you came all the way here for nothing.
Somebody was in your building. This is for your own safety, Toad. You called us, remember?
Yeah, I know, and I appreciate it, mate, but...
Fine, relax. We'll be out of here in a minute. I just want to check things out first.
All right. I just don't want to waste your time, is all.
Toad, is there somebody in...
Tea, whatever you like.
Somebody's in the building.
Grown-ups.
Or at least in the apartment.
Hey, you know
what?
Chatter? Flycatcher said you had a pretty awesome insect collection. I'd really love to see it. Is it in your room?
It has a weevil.
Cool.
Yep, that's Clementine. It's gotta be. Alright, Toad.
Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing.
Later, old Toad. Okay, so somebody broke in.
Huh?
The lock. It looks like somebody kicked in the door.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, a fucking lock's been busted for weeks, mate. Right, it's just like everything else in this bloody building.
Okay, so, Toad, how much is it going to take to get you to trust me that I can help you? Why are you protecting this other person?
And the lamp's broke, too.
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off a table.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he sucks at lying,
fell
but...
off the table.
You know, with this place, it's like living on a foundation of termites, it is. All so cheap, it's a wonder it stays standing as long as it does.
Mm-hmm. Alright, Toad, where the hell is he? Alright, Hottie, you take it easy. Thanks for stopping by.
You bleeding?
Why? Is that
blood? Still fresh.
Oh, well, I cut me end. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a wrap. Must have got some on the furnishments. Lamp in pieces, blood on the wall. It's awful, I know.
Sounds painful.
Oi, don't you go mother-enning now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog.
Mm-hmm. So I take it you just stabbed yourself with the end of this pitchfork.
There's more blood over here.
On the poker?
Yeah. What happened?
Oh, well, that's how it happened, didn't it?
God damn it, Toad, just fess up.
Toes and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing. If you're gonna say something, out with it.
Wait, you dropped it on your foot? You told me before that you cut your hand.
Yeah, no, I did cut my hand. I cut my hand first, and that made me drop the damn thing on my foot. A ruinous flip of events, really.
He's really stressing this.
Oh my god, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me?
Why?
I mean, things happen, you know.
This apartment's a goddamn mess, Toad. Looks like after a struggle or a fight. And I don't know why you cover for it. But I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not!
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
We'll see.
That more blood?
No, just a clean space in the dust. Did you move something?
Maybe one of Junior's toys or something? I mean, who knows?
Okay.
Bloody hell, Bigby. What's so he took... bit have you uncovered this time? I left the tap water running? Didn't stop the recycling? What's the point of all this, mate? Really?
That broken lamp used to be here, right? Just tell me what happened.
Nothing happened, mate. Nothing! And why did the lamp have to be there? Of all the blooming pointless inquiries. It's my own place. Don't you think I'll know what happens in it?
Because it wasn't on that table, Toad. There isn't any room in the electric outlets.
Huh? What are you-
It was plugged in over here, and now it's there.
I did some refiguring. Who fucking cares?
And not plug it in? Come on, Toad.
I just hadn't gotten around to it yet. You see how many damn plugs there are?
Okay, so obviously Toad sucks ass at covering shit, but...
some marks here on the windowsill.
But like I said, Junior leaves his toys around all the time.
These don't look like they're from a toy.
Oh, well.
SJ, welcome to stream, by the way.
When I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And
see,
I
the
had
thing
to
that I'm trying to figure out
window.
Is it the killer really? Or whoever is still in here.
Scared Junior off to death.
Right.
You heard the new Shakin' Stevens album yet?
I have yet to see the wolf form.
Junior was home. Why didn't he let you in?
It was the middle of a sodding night, Bigby. I'm supposed to wake him because his jammy daddy didn't remember to check his pockets. Bigby, come on. I'm begging for mercy over here, old boy. I was looking forward to a nice afternoon. Just me and me son, and you've taken up enough of a day with all this sniffing around at me private belongings. I'm sorry I called, really I am, but will you please just bugger off?
Not yet.
Not yet? No one fought anyone, Bigby. There wasn't any scrap. So when? When are you gonna leave? I mean, I feel like I'm on trial here. In me own bloody home! It's not seemly!
When you start telling me the truth, Toad?
Well, I've told you the truth, mate. Jesus Christ, what more do you want?
Toad, these stories have made no sense.
Come on, Toad.
You cut yourself on the poker. You didn't forget your keys. You want to tell me what's going on?
She doesn't think much of me, I don't think.
Oh, I wouldn't necessarily say that. Progress?
Depends on whether Toad... Damn it,
Mr.
Toad!
Mr. Toad, you're bleeding.
Fess up, Bubby.
Take off the hat.
Jeez.
It was that butcher.
Two points. All in!
Them down to their johnnies before you can tell which is which. He come bulging in, screaming about something the woodsman ate. Or thought he had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. I tried to go out the window, but he pulled me back in. It's been a hard morning, I could tell you that.
You know where the Tweedle went?
He mentioned something about Prince Lawrence's. I don't know if he'd already been there, was going there, but he said something about it. I would have told you. I wanted to, really, I did. But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy.
Well, I'm not gonna let that happen to
a coat. He wouldn't take it.
Whose coat?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. Sometimes.
Borrows?
I don't steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. I merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, yeah. We'll be taking
that's
the
one way
now,
to say it.
If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
All right. Fetch him the fur.
Matt, let's be honest. On this channel, my bot doesn't really like anybody. Grats, Rego. Grats, Queen.
Now I wouldn't wear it outside.
Wait. It's an envelope.
Fucking hell, of course it
is. Hey, David!
If my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. Do you want to...
Rego with the vengeance! Hey, Cavs! Oh, what? Cavs, we finished it.
Dilemma.
We finished it. It's painful. We finished it. The Telltale dress apart.
I'm sorry.
Painful.
Faith.
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't know. But maybe Lawrence does.
Well, it's been quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
Oh, yeah. No, this is way better. This is like...
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Better.
Thanks. See ya.
I thought I was gonna cry from Jurassic Park. Like, the stupidity was so high. It was on apocalyptic levels. I do not have Tales from the Borderlands yet. I've been, like, sitting, waiting to see if it would go on sale. But I do have Game of Thrones, because I got that for $10.
Does
like,
it
yeah!
always go that smoothly?
Not often.
So, the princes now?
Lawrence's, yeah. It's our best lead.
Dress Park was rough. It was...
When you put it that way.
I would rather... If I was, like, shackled to the game, I'd rather gnaw my hand off if I had to go through it again.
I don't want to stay here any longer than we have to, so let's just pick an approach and stick to it, okay?
I can't believe how much I really like Snow. I like her character.
When the magic mirror showed me this apartment, I think I saw a knife inside, covered in what looked like blood.
I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah.
Well, like I said, let's not overcomplicate things. You can question him while I look around for it.
And if you...
We're here on official Fable Town business. And we can be persuasive if necessary. Or you can.
Rega's like, it's vengeance time. Real fables, like genuine fables, none that
have
been Disney-fied.
Don't just peek into someone's house. Check if he's home.
They're dark, and I kind of love them.
Can you hear me?
I said the evil queen. Yeah. He's been dead for a while. Do we have forensics on this? Like, do we have anybody that can do that? Because I doubt sniffing the body's gonna help.
Oh my god.
Go get Dr. Swinehart. I'll stay with
him. No! No!
He's not dead? Wait, what? Wait, he knew Faith was going to die.
What is it that you're telling us? Bigby, water. Kitchen.
And I know where the water is? The kitchen is? Oh, I guess I do. Pay the rent next week. Pizza in the fridge. Please don't look for me.
Did you find it yet?
Swinehart is the forensics? Okay. A little creepy on the name, but, okie dokie. He's like Daredevil, isn't he?
If you have something to ask him, you should do it now.
Who did this to you?
Wait, what? Faith kills him. No. No, I don't believe that. I don't buy that. Talk about way to fall.
Do you still have that letter?
Yes.
Oh.
It's only two words, but he died without seeing them. I'm sorry. We need to figure out what happened here and find whoever did this.
Yeah, no, that would explain why the big bad is, terrifying. Because he's the bad guy in most things. Alright, so this is what you do. Is if you ever become a fable, guys, this is what you do. You get in as many stories as possible, and you are the biggest dick ever. So when you go back and you become a human and everything's like kosher, you're kind of like, eh, I'll be a nice guy now. I'm super strong.
When do you think that was taken?
Before all this.
Bullet hole.
Bullet passed through the chair. Yeah.
So long as there's no spoilers, I want to try to avoid spoilers. Bigby without a shirt. That's DLC, guys. You pay a dollar for that.
Edge of this pool, like something was here and got moved.
Okay, before we go check that out, it's like, I got a dollar.
Still a little sticky.
It's about this episode. So long as it's not spoiling anything, for the down the road, I'll be good.
Is that the same knife you saw in the mirror?
Yeah. I don't know why it's over here.
Either somebody moved it, Why the killer was still there? Or he moved it when he was about to die. Something's not. You know, this is what I have in my mind. You guys seen RoboCop, right? I'd buy that for a dollar. For whatever reason, when you guys started talking about Bigby, and then I was like, yeah, you just need a dollar. I was literally thinking...
Here's your damn dollar. Give me Shirtless Wolf now.
Oh, I thought it was going to be I buy that for a dollar, but okay. Just okay.
What is it?
This gun wasn't fired recently. Maybe a week ago.
Okay. Alrighty. So the gun was fired a week ago.
Fingerprints?
They'll be on the grip and the trigger.
I'm in the zone! AutoZone! No, I'm... This is what happens, like, I'm in the mood for, like, an adventure game, and I kind of just slightly might... Yeah. Love you too, Rav. Thanks for the $1.
That doesn't really help.
Or maybe it does. And I can smell... pills.
Prescription sleeping pills.
Man... I would just love if Sleeping Beauty needed sleeping pills to get her through the day or the night. It just, I would love that so much. I'm a dick. No, wait. Well, I give up. Ah, damn it. Okay. It could be. The alternative being she's like super hyper and she's always awake. Okay, there's the rest of the blood.
Son of a.
Okay, what's the letter say?
What is that?
Your face. I never meant to hurt. Okay, that'd be. Give me more time to read it.
It's stuck to the bed a little.
Ew.
My dearest Faith, I never meant to hurt you, and I cannot endure knowing that I have. This was for the best. I'll see you again. Love, your devoted Lawrence.
Oh, God. If they had it in the game, how cool would it be, like, they, she always wears gloves, or she has band-aids on her fingers. Oh, see, that, Matt, that's... that's bad. Even I'm saying that one's bad. Please don't look for me. Goodbye, Faith. So obviously she didn't kill him. Faucet works. Good to know. Good to know. Hang on. Okay, so there's nothing else I can touch.
Secondhand paperbacks. Old encyclopedias. Dusty. No one's read these in a while. Stay here!
No!
Okay, same perp as before. What the hell's he trying to find? It sure sounds like the dagger.
Hey!
Hey,
stop.
Tweedle! Come here, you little fat bastard.
Leave me alone!
Hulk smash! Bigby! Smash!
Come here, buddy. Or not. Oh, I hope you fall on your ass, you son of a bitch. Ow! That's not what I meant. Nailed it!
Hey!
Okay, Tweedle. You have got to stop running.
Easy up, Bigby. We're on the same side here.
You son of a bitch. Make me run after you.
I can see why you guys like Bigby.
Did you run?
What?
You have blood on your face. What's going on?
Fuck, man. Because you chased after me. The fuck was I supposed to do?
A man's dead.
I know how it looks, but I had nothing to do with that.
Bullshit. You're covered in blood.
Look, I was just asking him about the girl. That's all. When I mentioned her being dead, he freaked out. I figured someone had told him. How was I supposed to know? Shit. Fucker shot himself right in front of me. I couldn't stop him, man. You're looking for the woodsman, right? I know where he is. My guy says he's holed up at the trip trap. We can go over there right now, the both of us. My employer's looking to ask him a few questions, too. The fuck?
Come on, making me run.
Dumb? Yeah, it is. Look, it'd be much easier for you
I'm D. He's dumb.
At least I got one in.
He almost looked peaceful.
Cute.
Yep.
Funny. That helps.
Except you're lying in a dirty alley.
Yes.
With an open wound on the back of your head.
Yep. Where'd they go?
Well, after the one
he
guy
made
hit
me
you,
run.
And the other one finished kicking you.
That explains the ribs.
And they jumped into a car and drove off.
Explains the ribs.
Come on, get up.
Okay, Snow, no offense. How often do you get this shit kicked out of you?
He mentioned
I take it, not
trap.
Much.
Then that's where we'll go. I'll call a cab. Every time I think I'm getting a handle on what's going on, things just get more complicated. It feels like we're always a step behind.
The woodsman is the only lead we've got, and he was one of the last people to see Faith alive.
Getting actually,
some answers
you
out
have
we'll start to clear things
two
up.
Leads.
I hope you're right.
And you're not noticing the second one.
Bigby, be honest with me. Who do you think did this? I know it's still early, but I just feel a step behind. It's an uncomfortable feeling.
The guys who attacked me, D and Dumb, they've got something to do with all this.
You think so?
I don't know how or why just yet, but if you're asking, it's a hunch.
For the record, that's not the anger talking. That's just a matter of recalling a few things.
Thanks.
I
for
wish
you.
There was.
Wow, sexual tension. Not if he doesn't change. I'm pretty sure not if he doesn't change.
Go ahead. I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, it's.
Mid-change might be a little awkward.
It's nothing. I just.
All right, Rego, you take it easy, brother. Thanks for stopping by.
Seeing all this today, there are fables that are struggling worse than I'd imagined. We pay so much attention to the residents of the woodlands. You forget there's a whole community out there to serve. To have to turn to prostitution. I wish there was more we could do. This isn't how I thought it would be. But Crane runs things his own way.
You're doing your best. It's all anyone can do.
Obviously, you don't know what I do all day. Right now, I'm the gatekeeper, making sure none of these disenfranchised folks are, as he puts it, wasting his time.
You'll fix it.
I think the best part right now, get Crane off of freaking, whatever he's the leader.
It's just a broken system. The fables who walk in through the back door like Bluebeard, we have all the time in the world for them. You try and come in through the front door, through the proper channels, asking for anything needing help. Well, I turn you away.
Then change the system.
Now things are worse off than they've
ever been. Extreme!
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse, but not by much. Maybe this isn't for me. I thought public service was pure.
You should stick it out. There are fables that would give up a lot to be in the position you're in, and I think it's easier to change something from the inside.
You're telling me he's from within.
He's actually
sure
stuck as a human?
The advice I imagined hearing from you.
I'm full of surprises.
Basically, Extreme, fairy tales stuck in our modern time, dealing with modern Chicago
Maybe
issues.
Maybe you should handle this one.
Yeah, maybe I should.
Three apples. Cute. Bonnie.
Bigby. Just be careful. Please.
That even an option, Rev?
The same goes for you.
I will.
It's like New York, Chicago, right? It's one of those two. Or a variation of. Oh, so it's New York. Okay, so it's New York. Damn it. Please tell me you didn't crash. Okay. Sexer. I'm trying, but... The Trip Trap Bar, the Bronx. Hey, last I checked, it was.
What do you
depending
want,
on
Sheriff?
What you actually wearing and using and doing.
Official Fable Town business.
Oh, well, if it's official Fable Town business.
Look, I'm not even gonna ask where he is now, okay? I just want to know the last time he was here. That's all.
Who?
I'm being nice, so try again.
He hasn't been here for a few weeks. No, maybe. I don't know.
But and yeah,
he hasn't been here in a
somebody
while.
Somebody mentioned
if he's
it.
Been here at all,
the voice
which,
actress in Walking
I
Dead. He is. I just don't know which actor or character.
Don't let him tell you what to do. You're your own woman.
Well, this is me talking, Bigby. Fuck off.
All right. Yeah. There we go. Preparation for it. This. Yeah, buddy.
Look at that. Beware of dog bus stop.
Actually, Daisy's so badass these days that she'll resurrect hunters as well. So, there you go.
Oh, yeah. No, I remember that. That was actually working as intended.